Is it possible to generate images with multiple consistent characters in them using Leonardo AI? In this video, I'm going to show you how I took these two images of a man and a woman and used Leonardo AI's new character reference feature to create a variety of different scenes with both of them injected into them. I did a lot of testing, so I'll show you all the tips and tricks I learned to get the best results. First, I generated these photos of a man and a woman to use as character references for our images. This process works best if you use images that came from Leonardo. The settings I used for the images in the tutorial include the cinematic keynote preset to generate cinematic photos and the quality generation mode to get better results. Also, make sure you have photo reel turned on underneath advanced settings. In addition to the character references, we'll also need pose references that we want our characters to get mapped onto. I'll start with this photo of a man and a woman jogging in a park. I'm going to use this photo as a base template for what I want the final image to look like and transfer the poses from the pose reference image into the final photo with our characters mapped into it. Now, we can't generate character images for both joggers at the same time, so I'll crop the man and the woman into individual photos first. I'm on Windows, so I just use the snip tool for cropping. Then inside the image generation interface in Leonardo, I'll start by attaching a character reference by uploading the photo of the Hispanic woman. To create a photo of her jogging, I'm going to also use the post image guidance tool and upload the reference photo of the female jogger. Underneath the pose guidance icon, increase the slider a bit. Somewhere between 1.2 to 1.3 typically works okay, but sometimes you might need to go as high as 1.6 or 1.7. Then inside the prompt bar, type photo of a young Hispanic woman wearing a red collared shirt, jogging in a park on a bright sunny day. Let's also use a 1:1 aspect ratio. A square image will work fine. This produces an image of the Hispanic woman jogging based on our character reference photo with the body pose of the black woman from the reference. I've repeated this process for the Asian man. All I did was swap out the character reference, the pose reference, and also changed up the prompt to reflect that I'm prompting for the man. It's important to prompt for a similar background. For both of them, I went for a jog in a bright sunny park. What we're gonna do now is actually combine the photo of the female jogger and the photo of the male jogger using the canvas editor tool in Leonardo. Let's open up the canvas editor tool to combine the images together. First, using the upload image icon in the left menu bar, go to previous generations and add in the photo of the Asian man. If you're not familiar with the canvas editor, this purple square in the middle is where the AI will do inpainting or outpainting based on any images that you've uploaded. You can also adjust the zoom level at the top of the screen. And this pan icon in the left menu bar lets you drag the workspace around. Also, you can change the size and resolution of the purple rectangular inpainting space by using the settings menu on the right side of the screen. I'm going to make this a landscape photo. Also, make sure you have the correct model turned on. Since I use Leonardo Keynote to generate these images, I also use that to do the inpainting. I'm going to use the select tool to highlight the male jogger and drag him to the right side of the inpainting area and shrink him down to fit into the purple rectangle. Now, let's also upload the picture we created earlier of the female jogger. Using the select tool again, drag her to the left side of the inpainted region. This small black space that's inside the purple square and also in between the two images is where the AI will do the inpainting. Enter a prompt of something like a man and a woman jogging in a park on a bright sunny day, and the AI will inpaint the middle region for us. If you're happy with the way it looks, click on accept. To download the finished canvas, use the download artwork button over here. You want to make sure the lighting on the faces makes sense when you combine them. Here's another example where I combined images and the lighting on the woman's face and the man's face don't match. It looks like the light's coming from two different directions in this photo. Also, you may have noticed that the backgrounds don't blend together perfectly. It's not super noticeable, but there is some difference in the background color on the left and the right. I'll show you how to deal with this in the next example. So for this canvas, I use pose references from this image of a man and a woman sitting together and using the exact same process as I showed for the joggers in the park, I embedded my characters into them using character and pose reference guidance and put them on a rooftop in New York at night. The issue I have is that the backgrounds don't really match between the two individual images. If I just inpaint between them directly, the backgrounds don't connect well together and it looks disjointed. So let's cancel the inpainting and then use the eraser tool over here to remove the environment around the man on the right. It doesn't need to be super perfect, you can just roughly erase the area around him. You can also adjust the size of the eraser tool if you need more fine-grained control. Now, if we use a prompt of a man and a woman in a rooftop in New York at midnight, the impinged area makes a lot more sense. It looks like the man and woman are naturally in the same scene together. If you mess up and want to start from scratch, just use the clear canvas history icon here. You will need to make some adjustments to get this to work from time to time. Here's a pose reference of two people sitting together at a dinner table. For the male character, just using the pose reference feature isn't enough to get him to look towards the left. He's still facing us directly, which isn't what we want. So I changed the prompt to include side profile shot from the side. And I also included that he's smiling in the prompt to lighten the mood a bit. Sometimes using the pose reference just doesn't work at all. In this case, we can see that the woman's body gets totally deformed. The AI doesn't understand what we want it to do. So we have to give Leonardo a bit more guidance. In addition to using the pose reference feature, we also need to add on content reference. Then we'll upload the same exact guidance image that we use for the pose reference. Content reference takes the structure of the reference photo and applies it to the output image. I'll lower the content weighted down a bit from high to medium. Now when we generate the images, our female character will match the reference photo much more closely. Here's a more complex scene I tried to use as pose references. The AI generated images lack a little bit of coherency when you put them together. It is cool that Leonardo was able to make the woman look over her shoulder like in the reference photo. So what about closer, more personal interactions like this woman with her head on the man's shoulder? To create this photo, I first found a reference image with the poses that I wanted. Then inside Photoshop, I used the object detection tool to highlight and crop out each subject individually. I saved each of the individual reference poses with a transparent background. You can use any other object detection and background removal tool to replicate this step. Now I'm going to upload these reference photos as pose references and also content references next to my character photo. For more complex poses like this woman with a tilted head, you'll need content reference to make it work. Once my character images are generated, I'll place them inside the canvas editor. Using the eraser, I'm going to remove the environments around my characters so just their bodies are visible. Then I'll drag them together like this and add in a prompt like a man and a woman sitting on a couch inside a modern living room. Okay, so it's not perfect, the hands look a little weird, but it gets the general idea across. There are some pros and cons when it comes to multiple character scenes in Leonardo AI. The great part about it is the fine-grained control we get over the poses, and the characters also do look fairly consistent. The main issue I found though is that it's hard to get the lighting to look exactly the same for each character, which would give it a little bit of extra photorealism. If you want to learn more about the character reference tool in Leonardo, go and take a look at this complete breakdown I did over here. Also, make sure you subscribe if you want to see more tutorials like this.